for the parish of Bay Roberts Coombs Point at St. Matthew's Church. And we're doing a duo this morning. Myself and Byron Smith. I'm Pam Norman and it's Byron Smith. And we're filling in for Reverend Christine, who's off sick today. So we're flying by the seat of our pants. And we hope that we can bring you an inspirational service for your worship this morning. Our young people are involved in the service. They're recording and doing the PowerPoint. And we're very happy to have our wonderful One Foundation band that are backing us up this morning and making us look really good. So we're so happy to have them. And our young people are, we want you to bear with me and Byron, because we're new at this, and bear with our young people who are also new. And so we want to welcome you all here, and it's a nice crowd here this morning. We're so happy to see you all. And for all the people who are watching us on Facebook, we're very happy to be bringing you our service. So we'll begin our service. Thank you.
The opening selection is Here I Am to Worship and One Foundation.
My sin.
sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart. O God, who will not despise, seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the evil ones their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, and he will have compassion. And to our Lord, for we will richly return. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Page 49. Friends in Christ, as we prepare to worship Almighty God, let us with repentance and obedient heart confess our sins that we may obtain forgiveness in his infinite goodness and mercy. Together.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is our refuge and strength. Oh, come, let us worship.
You shall set it down before the Lord your God and bow down before the Lord your God. Then you, together with the Levites and the aliens you reside among you, shall celebrate with all the bounty that the Lord your God has given to you and your house. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, Denise. And Psalms, brought in home.
Shall give his angels charge over you. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High abides under the shadow of the Almighty. He shall say to the Lord, you are my refuge and my stronghold, my God in whom I put my trust.
He shall give his angels charge over you.
Because you make the Lord your refuge and the Most High habitation, there shall no evil happen to you, neither shall any plague come near you or dwell.
He shall give his angels charge over you.
For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep in all your ways. They shall bear you in their land hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon a lion and an adder. You shall trample the young lion and serpent under your feet, who is bound to me in love. Therefore I will deliver him. I will protect him, because he knows my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I am with him in trouble, and I will rescue him and bring him to honor. With life long I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Jesus, light of the world, cause we find it all.
spirit to man. Please remain standing. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become a loaf of bread." And Jesus answered and said, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone." Then the devil led him up and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And the devil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all this authority, for it has been given over to me, and I will give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will all be yours." And Jesus answered him, "It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then the devil took Jesus to Jerusalem and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to protect you, and on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against the stone." And Jesus answered him, "It is said, do not put your Lord God to the test." When the devil had finished every test, he departed from him until an opportune time. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We'll be seated. A little change in the order of service, because I was scheduled to do a report on our Synod, which is our church diocese meetings that we held last weekend. And so I was going to do that report at the end, but since Reverend Christine is not here, she's ill, and can't do the sermon, I'm going to put my report in here, and then I'll be followed by Paige, who's going to do the children's talk for our service today. So this report is on the 32nd session of the Diocese Synod of Eastern Newfoundland Labrador, Part A, which is the business part of the Synod. And Part B will be coming in the fall to address other work of the diocese. It began with the bishop's charge and moved toward finances and elections. A large part of the business center was focused on future plans for the reorganization of the diocese. A plan for the restricting, for the reorganization has been formulated, and I have taken the following excerpts from the plan to report to you, our parish. So this is taken exactly as from the plan that they have brought. In October 16, 2018, the Venerable Gregory Mercer and his team presented a commission report. As a diocese, we were working through the commission report in various creative ways and establishing partnerships with neighboring parishes and community organizations. Then, in March 2020, brought the global pandemic to our shores and we entered into a lockdown. You all know. Every major global event creates change, this thus changing humanity and society forever. As a church, we have been changed, and we cannot assume that life will return to pre-COVID days. The pandemic has changed how we worship, how we gather, how we financially support, and how we function as a church. In the midst of these changes, we have proven how quickly we can adapt as people of God to continue the mission of the church. While we have found new strengths in the ways to be the church and how we fulfill its mission, we have also discovered some weaknesses. These weaknesses are most evident in how we financially support our ministry. In compiling this plan forward, we have discovered that heavy reliance on fundraising from some of our parishes was what it kept it going. The pandemic had certainly changed many of the traditional fundraising events and thus created some difficult situation for parishes in supporting their ministry and in turn the ministry of the diocese. The advent of the Canadian Emergency Wage Subsidy, CEWS, by the federal government and the diocese support plan, which ended August 2020, had been a lifeline for qualifying most of the parishes. We are now in a place where we can no longer avoid the reality of the current situation in our parishes and our dioceses. The Diocese of Eastern Newfoundland and Labrador have been experiencing a devastating effect on the revenue of many of the parishes, and in particular, the budget of the diocese. This is due to slow growth and the impact of COVID-19. A subcommittee of the Finance Committee of the Diocese was appointed to prepare a budget for the diocese for 2021, and also to prepare a plan forward for the ongoing ministry and financial stability of the Ministry of the Diocese. The final product was a plan named The Way Forward. The plan clusters parishes together to work better toward utilization of our resources. I'm only going to present Cluster A, which is the plan for the reorganization of this area for the reorganization of the diocese. Cluster A includes the following churches: Church of the Resurrection in South River, St. Luke's in Portigray, St. Mark's in Shearstown, St. John Colby's Point, and St. Matthew's in Bay Roberts. The report recommends that we work together to utilize our resources. They also had specific adjustments as follows: to reduce our clergy positions to 2 full-time clergy, reduce our housing allowance and rectories, and this would assume the sale of the rectories in Shearstown and Portigray. In the coming weeks and months, and maybe even years, our vestries will meet together to discuss, to plan, and to see how we can move forward in a life-giving way to these recommendations. If you would like a full copy of The Way Forward, that's the plan, please call the parish office, leave a message, or maybe the secretary may be there. If not, leave a message and a copy will be emailed to you. Thank you. Here's what Jesus
him only. Next, Satan took Jesus to Jerusalem and led him up to the highest point on the temple. He said to Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here. God will send his angels to rescue you." Of course, God will keep Jesus safe, but Jesus quoted the scripture, "Do not put the Lord your God to the test." Do you know what the devil did? He gave up. He said, "I'll come back another day and try again." The next time the devil tempts you to do something wrong, look in the Bible and see what the Bible says. Then, do what Jesus did. Answer Satan with the scripture. Let us pray. Dear God, help us use your word and follow Jesus' example in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Hear, O Israel. Hear, O Israel. The Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. This is the first and great command.
Second is
love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these.
With confidence and trust, let us pray to the Lord, saying, "Lord, have mercy."
Lord, have mercy.
For the church, that we may recognize our identity as members of the body of Christ and manifest the good news in our lives, our families, and our workplaces. In our tri-diocesan intercessions, we pray for the parish of Catalina, their rector, the Reverend Eli Cross, and their six congregations. We pray for the Cathedral Parish of St. John the Baptist, their rector, the Venerable Roger Whalen, and Vicar Missional, the Reverend Khalil Kincaid. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. For the mission of the Church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those preparing for baptism and confirmation, and for their teachers and sponsors, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace in the world, that a spirit of respect and reconciliation may grow among nations and peoples, remembering especially the people of Russia and the Ukraine, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, remembering especially Robin, Ella, Bill, Alan, Blake, Frida, and Helen. At this time, we would also like to remember Gary Jorin family as they mourn the loss of Gary's father, Harry Jorin. The people of for refugees, prisoners, and all in danger, especially the people of the Ukraine, that they may be relieved and protected. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all whom we have injured or offended, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For grace to amend our lives and to further the reign of God, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ alone, I hold.
refuge and our strength. Receive all we offer you this day, and through the death and resurrection of your Son, transform us to his likeness. We ask this in his name.
Yeah.
stay here, dismissal. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thank you.